गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट रबर. फर्स्ट इज द नेचुरल रबर. रबर इज एन अ नेचुरल पॉलीमर बिकॉज दिस रबर इज ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम प्लांट्स एंड दिस रबर इज पजेसेस द इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी. इट इज ऑल्सो टर्म्ड एज अ इलास्टोमेरिक पॉलीमर. द पॉलीमर चेन आर हेल्ड टुगेदर by the weak intermolecular forces. You also saw in the elastomers. These elastomers is also contain weak intermolecular forces. These weak binding forces like a weak van der Waals forces and these weak van der Waals forces is permit the polymer to be stretched like a spring. A few cross-linked are introduced between the chain and they help polymer to retract to its original position after forces is released. The rubber is a manufacture formed rubber latex and which is a colloidal dispersion of a rubber in a water. Means this rubber latex is a colloidal dispersion of rubber in water and this rubber latex is obtained from rubber. This natural polymer is a linear polymer of the isoprene and this isoprene is also known as a 2-methyl 1,3-butadiene and these are also called as a cis-1,4-polyisoprene. When n number of isoprene molecule is undergo the polymerization reaction and we get cis-polyisoprene. Here 1/4 addition is occur. Then another natural rubber is a guttapercha. Guttapercha is a naturally occurring isomer of the rubber, but in this guttapercha, all the double bond are trans. You see in the isoprene, in this isoprene, all the double bond are in cis position. But in guttapercha, all the double bond are in trans position. This is the difference between these two monomer. Like a rubber, guttapercha is excluded by a certain trees. And this guttapercha is harder and more brittle than a rubber, than a normal natural rubber. This natural rubber have a property like they become soft a high temperature like 335 Kelvin and they are brittle at a low temperatures less than 283 Kelvin and they shows the high water absorption capacity and that's why they are soluble in the non-polar solvent and they are non-resistant to attack by oxidizing agent. To improve upon these physical property, a process of vulcanization is carried out. In this vulcanization process, rubber is react with sulfur and it forms the vulcanized rubber. Which process is occur in this vulcanization rubber? In vulcanization rubber is heated about 3 hours with sulfur. The amount of sulfur is 3 to 10% and the temperature is 125 to 140 degree Celsius. Rubber hydrocarbon is a combined with the sulfur atom and form the sulfur beads. Here you see, when natural rubber is react with sulfur catalyst in presence of heat, and you see the sulfur bridge between these natural rubber. Means here in the rubber hydrocarbon is combined with sulfur and form the sulfur bridges. And this resulting product means vulcanized rubber is a tough, non-elastic, and they are resistant to heat. It become a non-abrasive and non-affected by a chemical. There are two type of vulcanization of rubber. First, when rubber is made with 1-3% of the sulfur, is the soft and stretchy, and it is used to make a rubber band. When natural rubber is made with 3-10% of the sulfur, it is a very more rigid, and it is used to manufacture of tire for automobile and etc. It is the reaction of vulcanization of rubber. Here two natural rubber is a react with sulfur catalyst in presence of heat, and sulfur is formed the bridge between these two natural rubber, means two isoprene. Then second is the synthetic rubber. Synthetic rubber is any vulcanizable rubber like a polymer, which is the capable of getting a stretch to be twice its length, and however it returns to its original shape and size as soon as the external stretching force is released. Thus, synthetic rubber are either homopolymer of the 1,3-butadiene derivative or copolymer of the 1,3-butadiene or its derivative with another unsaturated monomer. First is the neoprene. Neoprene or polychloroprene is formed by a free radical polymerization of the chloroprene. Means when n number of chloroprene molecule is react with potassium persulfite, and we get a neoprene. This neoprene is a superior resistance to vegetable and mineral oil. It is used in manufacture of conveyor belts, gaskets and hoses. Then second synthetic rubber is the buna, and when 1,3-butadiene and acrylonitrile is react with each other in presence of peroxide catalyst, here copolymerization reaction is occur and buna N is a form. Means when 1,3-butadiene is react with this acrylonitrile, the double bond in 1,3-butadiene is break and form a single bond, and when single bond in a 1,3-butadiene in a polymerization product, double bond is formed in it. Means here you see CH2 double bond, CH single bond, but here CH2 single bond, CH double bond. Means it is the difference between monomer and polymerization reaction, polymerization product. It is a buna N is a resistant to the action of petrol, lubricating oil and organic solvent. That's why they are used in making of the oil seals and tank lining. Then Third is the Buna S. When 1,3-butadiene is react with styrene and we get a Buna S rubber, it is obtained by the polymerization of butadiene and styrene in the ratio of 3:1 in presence of sodium. When 1,3-butadiene is react with styrene in presence of heat and we get this Buna S rubber. The use of Buna S is also vulcanized and they are used in making of the tire for the vehicle and they are also used as a rubber soles and in making a waterproof shoes. Then fourth is the thiokol. Thiokol is also a synthetic rubber and they are made by the polymerization of the ethylene dichloride and sodium polysulfide. Means when ethylene dichloride and sodium polysulfide is react with each other and thiokol is prepared. In the presence of sulfur atom in the polymeric chain, it is make it inert on less reactive. This is the structure of thiokol, CH2SSCH2. This thiokol is used in making of the hoses, engine gasket, and the mixture of the thiokol with the oxidizing agent, it is used as a rocket fuel. Then our last topic is the biodegradable polymer. This polymer that cannot be break into the small segment by the enzyme catalyzed reaction, they require the enzyme are produced by microorganism. It is a known fact that carbon-carbon bond of the chain growth polymer are inert to enzyme catalyzed reaction and hence they are non-biodegradable. First, biodegradable polymer is the PHBV. The full name of PHBV is the polyhydroxybutyrate co-beta hydroxyvalerate. It is the copolymer of 3-hydroxybutyric acid and 3-hydroxypentanoic acid. Means when 3-hydroxybutyric acid and 3-hydroxypentanoic acid, pentanoic acid is react with each other and we get a polyhydroxybutyrate co-beta hydroxyvalerate. It is the chemical reaction of the PHBV. First is a 3-hydroxybutyric acid and second is the 3-hydroxypentanoic acid and it is the PHBV. Then second is the polyglycolic acid and polylactic acid. Polyglycolic acid is also known as a PGA and polylactic acid is known as a PLA and these both are biodegradable polymer. They are used for post-operative stitches and these are bioabsorbable structures. This is the polyglycolic acid and second is the polylactic acid and then third is the nylon 2,6. Nylon 2,6 means first monomer is contain the 2 carbon in it and second monomer is contain the 6 carbon in it. When Glycine is contain the 2 carbon in it. Glycine is a NH2CH2COOH. And second is the amino caproic acid. And when they are linked with each other and form the nylon 2,6, and this nylon 2,6 is a biodegradable. When this NH2CH2COOH is react with NH2CH25COOH, here one hydrogen from NH2 group and OH from glycine means COOH group and is removed, and here CONH amide group is formed, and this nylon 2 nylon 6 is formed. Here condensation polymerization reaction is occur because here one small molecule is produced. Then molecular masses of polymer. The polymer sample contain a chain of the varying length, and thus its molecular mass is expressed as an average as defined in the following. The first is the number average molecular mass. Number average molecular mass is also known as MN. MN is equal to epsilon I Ni Mi and upon epsilon I Ni. And this is the mass average molecular mass. It is also known as MM, epsilon I Ni Mi square upon epsilon I Ni Mi.